Ricky, your thoughts on the result and performance tonight?
I think individually there was some really, really good performances. I thought as a team, I thought we performed reasonably well in the first half. I thought we had the lion's share of the game. I thought we controlled the moments that we wanted to control on and off the ball. But what we lacked was that finishing touch, that clinical edge, and I felt we could have been two or three goals up in the first half. I thought I was pretty pleased with the guys' level of performance, but I wanted them to have that real, as I just said, clinical edge to go and punish Broxburn for the chances that we got. You know, like, Reg had a good chance, it was a penalty claim, Keane's probably got to shoot in that situation as well, there was a few others. So that's probably a learning. I think second half, we huffed and puffed, to be honest with you. I was annoyed with them a little bit in the second half. I don't think it was much a game. They could have stole it from us, definitely. They had a great cross in and he's missed from close range, the guy up front. So I'm a bit frustrated because I felt we could have had the 3 points in the pocket.
Always good to see the unbeaten run carrying on, but it'll be a tough few days. Obviously had the game at the weekend, a game tonight, and in a couple of days' time we've got Hearts B at Alliance Park. So the fixtures are kind of piling up just now. How do you manage the squad through such a hectic schedule?
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously it's down to injuries as well, but I mean, that's just what the boys get. You know, they get paid to play football, and you know what's better than a Saturday, Tuesday, Saturday situation. So they should all be desperate to play. I would say if I'm a sub tonight, I'd be annoyed because I felt we didn't play the way. So if I'm Lennon Walker, for example, right, who needs the ball at his feet, who's top quality player, he's been carrying that wee injury for a wee while, so I've been giving him a rest. And you're talking about managing the squad, so I don't want to put him in a situation that's going to make that worse. But I'd be annoyed at the fact that we didn't play the type of football in the second half that would allow me to make that switch to put him on and then find the pockets and find those kind of danger areas and take that a little bit more risk of putting an attacking player on. It was something that's been in my head. Regardless, so I'd be annoyed at his teammates for that, not passing the ball well enough to convince me that he's the man to go in the park. But in terms of managing squad, that's part of the job. Obviously, John came off injured, so hopefully he'll be okay for the weekend. But the guys are fit, they're strong, they're athletic, so it's about recovery. Won't do too much on Thursday night. And yeah, we'll see where we're at in that situation. But I want the guys who are finding themselves on the bench tonight, I want to see them in training, I want to see them push, I want to see them being aggressive to get themselves in the starting line.
And yet another goal for Ross McNeil tonight. How lethal has he been so far this campaign?
He has, there's no doubt about it. I tend to look at, rather than the finishing touch, and Ross is great, you know, he's great at that. He really goes and finishes chances when he gets them. And we need more of that, of course. But I tend to look at how the ball ends up there, you know, in what way we go and create a situation, because I want to be able to score goals in a variety of different ways, whether it's balls over the top, or crosses, or cutbacks, or shots for the edge, or interplay in the edge of the box, whatever it may be. Or long balls or whatever it is. So that's what I look at, and I felt in the second half we huffed and puffed to get to that situation. I don't remember us having a good chance in the second half, so we should be frustrated at that. But we'll play for Roscoe for another goal.
And obviously we're still top of the table for now, so how's the morale going to change in him?
Fine, but we just, like, we keep taking it game to game, like we keep talking about the table and, or you guys talk about the table, and I understand the question completely, but we're just like, okay, we see view it as a bit of a process of just continuing to work on each game as it comes, try our best to win the game, be positive, improve the boys as a team, and then we'll see where we are towards the end of the season. And if we're still up there, then we'll have deserved that, and then we can go and make a final push. But for me, the table doesn't really come into it too much at the moment. I appreciate it does play a part, of course, and it's a confidence thing to say that, right, you know what, we're top of the table, and well deserved to that. But I think there's a lot more to come for them, that's for sure.
All right, thank you very much, Ricky.
All right, cheers.